I've been working on an online multiplayer VR shooter written in Python for a while now. Python and VR aren't really known for mixing, which is why my game GunSlaw VR dominates the search results for Python VR. As a result, I've largely had to blaze my own trail when it comes to software architecture. And to be clear, with exception to shaders and build tools, every bit of GunSlaw's code is written entirely in standard Python. I figured it'd be helpful to some people to break it down. OpenXR is the standard cross-platform API for interacting with nearly every modern VR device. PyOpenXR is a module that provides what we call bindings, which implement Python functions that call OpenXR functions under the hood. This gives the game fairly direct access to input like the position of your eyes or your hands and the buttons being pressed. Rendering to the headset is a bit more complicated. I primarily use Modern GL for rendering, which is an object-oriented interface for the graphics library OpenGL, which makes use of system resources like the GPU to render stuff. It starts with the eye positions I get from OpenXR, which I use to place cameras in my implementation of a 3D game engine to render a scene in Modern GL using a lot of 3D math running on PyGLM, a math library. The resulting scenes for the eyes are OpenGL resources representing flat images the eyes will see. In order to get these images into the headset, I have to do a little bit of code glue in PyOpenGL, which are the more raw and less pretty bindings for OpenGL, to pass what are called frame buffers to OpenXR and eventually to the VR headset, so that the players can see the scene. Most VR games also have a window on your PC's desktop so others can watch what you're doing, or you can screen record what's happening in the game. To do this, I had to do a bit of code glue with PyOpenGL to pass the scene from the right eye to PyGLFW, which are the bindings for GLFW, which gives me an interface to an actual application window in Windows so I can show the game on the desktop. If you notice, I've also got Pygame over here. It's actually not connected to any low-level resources in this use case. I purely use it to render UI elements like the watch face, bomb screen, sights, menus, etc. The render textures are converted in software to use the data format for OpenGL textures without using any of Pygame's features for low-level graphics interfaces. Those textures are used during the main world rendering I do with Modern GL. Over on the far left, I have listed PyWavefront, which is the module I use to parse OBG 3D model data. All the way on the other side, we can see PyOpenAL, the Python bindings for OpenAL, basically the audio equivalent of OpenGL, which standardizes the interface to machine audio interfaces. Finally, since GunSlaw VR is an online multiplayer game, there's a large netcode component. I've written my own framework, also purely in Python, called ShobNet, so the game client netcode and server instance can be written in Python. ShobNet uses the built-in Python sockets library to interact with network interfaces and send data over the internet. I've pinned the old spaghetti open source version of this game in the comments if you want to look into making your own VR games with Python.